My name's Nancy Knowlton. I'm a marine scientist here at the Smithsonian's National Museum of Natural History. And I study coral reefs and actually just everything that lives in the ocean. I've really been interested in science for pretty much as long as I can remember. When I was in college, I was still interested in biology, but I didn't actually know the kind of biology I was interested in. And in fact, I think my least favorite courses were about the topics I work on now. But after I graduated from college, I spent a year working in the laboratory of Dr. Ruth Turner. She was a marine biologist. She was the first woman to go down to the deep sea in Alvin, a very famous submersible, which is actually still used today. And she really inspired me, and that's how I went from being a general purpose biologist to really a committed marine biologist. I started off doing animal behavior on these tiny little snapping shrimp that live with sea anemones. In 1980, Hurricane Allen came and swept by the North Coast and really pulverized all the coral reefs and turned it, looked like an underwater parking lot after the hurricane passed through. Really just dropped everything and joined a team of people to figure out what happened as a function of the hurricane and how the reefs would recover. And then that really led into a whole stream of work about that eventually led to my conservation work today, and that's because those reefs never did recover. When water gets above about 1 degree centigrade or 2 degrees Fahrenheit over the normal maximum for the area, that symbiotic relationship breaks down and the corals undergo what's called coral bleaching. If it's severe, and it often is, it leads to the death of the coral.
And of course, the future is also not looking too good, especially under a business as usual scenario.
I came to realize that just talking about all the bad things happening to reefs was not going to really change the conversation in a way that needed to be changed.
So I started 7 years ago, and Nancy brought me on to the Ocean Portal team and took me under her wing. As the threat of climate change is continuing to grow, the science that we do here at the museum has to evolve at the same time. We have scientists and researchers in the lab. We're using cutting-edge technology to understand the impact of humans on the oceans. Then what I do is I take that science and share it with audiences around the world so that they can understand it.
So next generation sequencing technology is where we sequence millions and millions of strands of DNA at the same time instead of one at a time. That lets us sequence thousands and thousands of marine organisms at once and get a picture of the entire community at once. It's pretty clear that in many cases, biodiversity is linked to healthier ecosystems, right? So ecosystems that do things that are helpful to humans, whether it's making fish for us to eat, or cleaning out the pathogens out of the water, or filtering water. We really need to understand why and how these ecosystems are changing and how that might affect humans in the future.
So I went from studying snapping shrimp living with sea anemones to studying the effects of a hurricane to studying the fact that there were many more species of corals out there than people realized. And that's been the story of my whole career, one discovery leading to another and almost impossible to predict. And those changes were inspired by things I saw underwater, events that happened. It makes you wake up every morning and be excited just by the beauty, in addition to, of course, all the cool scientific questions you can ask.